Today, we're going to be talking about the preparation that I put into my Appalachian Trail Thru-Hike of 2020. I am starting in 1 week from today. It won't be 1 week from today when this posts, but first I just wanted to kind of talk about my appreciation for those of you who have subscribed and liked and just been following along and have offered great words of encouragement. Thank you so much. That means a lot to me. But if you do want to keep following along, be sure to click subscribe, like the videos. Please comment, ask me questions. I love seeing the comments. Honestly, they've been great. So thank you for that support. So let's get right into it. My preparation, I was able to kind of break down into four different categories. So the four categories are financial, physical, mental, and social. So I'm going to go into depth on all these. So let's just get started. Another thing I want to mention before we start on everything is just that I have never completed a thru hike. I haven't even set 1 foot on one. I have completed a 100-mile backpacking trip. The preparation for that was very different from this. Please understand that these are the things that I've been doing to prepare through my research. I hope that you'll find some value, or they'll give you some ideas on how you can prepare, or at least they'll just get you excited to do your own research and figure out what you need to do to get out on the trail and start your first thru hike. Before we get into the four categories, there's one thing that I think is very, very important to anybody aspiring to do a thru hike. And when you feel like you're realistically close to making that decision, the biggest difference for me was I just up and picked a start date. That start date ended up changing, which was fine. I mean, I picked it 6 months in advance of when I was leaving. Actually, it was 7 months in advance from when I was leaving originally, but I got a little excited and I decided I wanted to move it up. So I did. But picking that date was very crucial. It made things more real to me. You know, I let my manager at work know that I had picked a date, that was a day I'm going to be leaving. Aside from all of like the work things that I had to do up until then, I had a lot of just through hike preparation to do. Pick that date. It is seriously going to make things feel so much more real. So first thing I want to talk about is the financial aspect of things. I guess first was actually having a goal with my finances for my through hike. I really wanted to have a very modest budget going into this. I did that for a number of reasons. I knew that I didn't want to blow all of the money that I had saved up, because when I come home, you know, I might not have a job right away. So I wanted to make sure that I would have money when I got back. With that in mind, I was able to set up a budget, a savings plan, so I could be ready for my start date. So when I say modest, I mean it. I mean it pretty modest. Like, I don't plan on doing a lot of 0 days in town. I'm planning to just get in, get out, get the supplies that I need so I can get back on the trail. Another one kind of leg up I have on that is I don't drink alcohol, so I'm gonna save a lot of money there. Of course, I love food, so I might just end up balancing out, but I'm gonna try and do my best. I've heard that hiker hunger is a very real thing. I haven't yet experienced it in my own hiking repertoire, but I know that it's going to happen eventually. So hopefully we can stick with that budget. So my modest budget, I talked to somebody once that I just met randomly who had done the Appalachian Trail, and she had done it, I think she did it in just about 5 months, and she spent $2,500, which I was super impressed with. So I've set a modest budget of $3,000, but I am prepared to do more if necessary. So I guess, how did I save my money? It kind of started, well, I guess it started back in 2018 when I kind of wanted to really try out. What I did was I actually spent a lot of my time from the latter half of 2018 to about the end of March in 2019 converting my van into a camper van. I wanted to do this so I could maximize my weekends. I didn't plan to live in it like a typical, you know, van lifer would. I wanted it to facilitate my outdoor activities. And by the time that I finished it, I took it out that summer of 2019, and I had a lot of fun in it, but I really found myself just spending more time in like driving as opposed to being on trails and finding good places to park, free places to park with views, of course, because, you know, I got caught up in all that. I just realized that I actually wanted to backpack more, and leaving like, well, first an expensive vehicle with so much expensive things inside of it and so much time and labor put into it, leaving that just by itself at a trailhead for a number of days made me feel uneasy. Then the appeal of getting completely out of debt hit me hard, and I was like, you know what, if I sold this van, I could get completely out of debt. It was actually by the end of July I ended up selling it, and it was able to help pad my savings account a little bit as well, simultaneously while getting me out of debt, which was a really great thing. That was one way that I was able to actually get a chunk of savings toward my thru-hike, because it wasn't shortly after that that I actually did decide that I was going to be hiking, and I picked the day that I was going to be hiking. So for about 6 months, I was able to save $500 a month to add to that savings that I got from the sale of my van. Got a tax return, which is really helpful. That was kind of how I was able to plan financially for my thru-hike. I also stopped eating out all the time, which I was doing. So sacrifices will have to be made, I think, especially if you're planning in a 6 month time frame and you didn't just, you know, sell a really awesome camper van. All right, so the next category of preparation that I went through was physical. Of course, it's been an ongoing thing. And this is actually where I'm ashamed to say I spent the least amount of effort. I used to hike like 3 to 4 times a week, especially in 2018. The construction of my van like consumed my life for 9 months. And then, yeah, I just kind of didn't do it as often. I gained a lot of weight. So, you know, there was a lot of things that kind of went into my physical preparation. I am not someone who has an issue with losing too much weight and worrying about my health from being too thin. I didn't put on any weight intentionally. I did put on a lot of weight in that time frame because I wasn't as active as I was the previous year. Other than that, it was probably about January where I started going on walks every morning on the weekends, just on the Parkway Trail that's kind of near my house. I would do a 6 mile loop on Saturday and Sunday, and then every day at lunch I had 30 minutes. I'd go on a walk around kind of like the area, and I'd get about a mile and a half in 30 minutes. Now that I don't have a job, which is something that's weird, like it's Tuesday, it's my second day of unemployment, and it just feels like I'm taking time off. I've been doing that every morning around the Parkway Trail, so about 6 miles every day. Plan tomorrow to kind of up to an 8 mile loop that I do occasionally. But other than that, I have been doing a few day hikes. It's going to be tougher for the last, you know, 7 days here because I just sold my car yesterday. So I don't have a car to get to trailheads and I'm not very close to any. Guess I could walk to them. I mean, why not? But yeah, that's kind of all that went into my physical preparation. I know from experience that like as I'm on the trail, I will gain that physical capability and get my trail legs eventually. Some people like to get all their training in before they go out. Some people just get on the trail and do their training there. And I'm definitely in the latter group in this situation. The next category of preparation that I'd like to talk about is the mental side of things. I think this is becoming more and more common for people to be aware of and to focus on, but it might be one of those, still might be one of those things that people just miss. You're gonna be walking every single day for the good part of 5, 6, maybe even 7 months. In those times, you should expect some boredom. While you're in beautiful places, the environment is not always gonna offer you tip-top entertainment like you'd hope it would, or like you've experienced that it would. I think becoming aware of this being an obstacle is crucial to your success or to you, you know, reaching the goals that you've set for yourself on your thru hike or your long hike. Yeah, just make sure that you're aware that the mental preparation is a big part of what's going to help you reach those goals. Now, I have not completed a thru hike, so I can't say that, yes, this absolutely 100%, you know, gave me the success that I was looking for. But I know that I feel like I'm a lot more equipped to go into this with, you know, a clear head, understanding that those obstacles are going to come and finding ways that I'm going to need to be able to overcome adversity, you know, terrible days of rain, terrible days of aching feet, or whatever it is. I know that, you know, I was prepared for this. I was expecting this. One of the ways that I really kind of prepared for this was I read the book Appalachian Trials by Zach Davis. I read it twice actually, and you know, hearing someone who's done the trail before, he wrote this book after he did the Appalachian Trail back in 2011, and he goes through a lot of the things that hikers, thru-hikers, go through while hiking the trail. Taking that and, you know, reaching out to even maybe people you know who have hiked, talking to them, say, hey, what mental hurdles did you have to overcome? Or what mental preparation did you do or would you recommend to me so that I can, you know, reach the goals that I've set for myself? I highly recommend picking up his book. It was very helpful to me. Like I said, I read it twice And it really kind of introduced some ideas into my mind that I never would have been able to discover otherwise. Part of my kind of mental preparation that I've taken upon myself is actually during those kind of city walks on the Parkway Trail that I've been doing. I've been doing them very early in the morning, you know, on weekends when, you know, I can totally sleep in if I want to. And it's winter right now, so a lot of the times the conditions are just bad. Like they're always cold. Sometimes it's snowing, sometimes it's raining, sometimes it's a mix of both, and sometimes I'm like sliding on ice, you know, just things like that aren't ideal, and I could easily just stay at home, cuddled up in my bed, could turn on Netflix and watch Saturday morning cartoons, you know, like, but I wasn't doing that. I was getting out there and I was forcing myself to do something that maybe I wasn't really looking forward to, or, you know, doing something other than what I'd rather be doing was what I've been doing to try and prepare myself mentally for that. And, you know, getting a face full of snow, collecting in my beard and everything, you know, to kind of help my mental preparation, because I know those days are going to be on the trail. I also listen to podcasts and research things on, you know, YouTube is a really great one, of course. The Trek.co is a really awesome blog for content. Backpacker Radio, Trail Correspondence, which I will actually be participating in this 2020 season on the Appalachian Trail, which I'm really excited about. Check them out. Listening to other previous hikers who have done these things, and they hit on mental things all the time, like the mental preparation that is required. Yeah, they talk about physical things, they talk about financial things, they talk about everything that I'm talking about today, but these are people who are reporting from the trail, or people who are reporting after they finish the trail, which is just invaluable information for someone who is planning and preparing to do a thru hike of their own. Okay, so on to the fourth and last category of preparation, which is one that I think people probably overlook. It was something that I didn't even realize that I had done until I was really contemplating what I was going to be putting into this preparation video. And that is like the social or relationship side of things as far as leaving. Because if you think about it, I mean, you really don't even have to think about it. You are going to be leaving everything behind for about 6 months, and that includes people, loved ones, people who are very close to you, people that might even be relying on you. So the first thing I did was I started planting the idea in the minds of people who were close to me, mainly my family and some of my friends. I started like just dropping little hints like, yeah, we'll be here next summer because I want to hike the Appalachian Trail, or I want to do a thru hike, or whatever it was. So as I started to like introduce the idea of this to those who I really cared about and were close to me, it started to become a lot more real in my mind, which was something that became very important to me, because eventually I was just like, you know what, I've been talking about this a lot, I'm just going to pull the trigger and do it. And then I picked a date, which was life-changing, really. It was just like, oh my gosh. So everything shifted to preparing for my thru hike. So once I had actually picked that start date and I knew I was going to be going and I had committed myself to it, I started telling a few more people here and there. I didn't want to tell a bunch of people at first. I didn't want to like widely spread it because I still had 6 months of like a job that I was going to be at before I was going to be leaving. I started telling more and more people, making it become more and more real to me, which motivated me to prepare more on my finances, my physical side, and my mental side of things. Definitely, I would recommend that. It really helped me in my preparation. I'm hoping it really pays off at the end. So around that time, you know, I told my manager, I told a few other people I wanted to know or needed to know. From there, the next step was when it got close enough, I let everyone know. And those were people that I still hadn't told who I would see every day, or I was in, you know, who are friends or coworkers or whatever, and family. And then I announced it on my social media platforms that I use, which was really just Instagram at the time. I even logged into Facebook, which I don't do like ever, and announced it there. Because I think once you do that, and you can do that earlier, of course, I was waiting because I didn't want, you know, I wanted to make sure I was still being effective at my job and not get like too excited to go to where I couldn't focus on anything else. Making that announcement, like it just opened up a whole new world. It was like, everybody knows, or anybody that cares to know, knows now. That extended out into starting this YouTube channel, something that I mainly did because I was just too anxious to go. I was feeling like I had a little bit of the blues, the pre-trail blues. Yeah, and this was something that I started doing to kind of help kind of cope with that and to help build the excitement and not be so anxious. Let people know. especially in your social circles, the people that you care about, start planning that idea early. And then all it does is it makes it more real for you and it gets you excited. I was very fortunate that everyone that I told was very, very supportive and continued to be, which is seriously so incredible. You hear of people who like tell their family and they're just like, are you crazy? And if my family's thinking that, they're not like dwelling on it. Like they very well might think that. You know, I might have friends who are like, you're crazy, what are you doing? But they're supporting me because they know it's something that I'm passionate about. One of the other things that I did as far as like my social preparation was I actually started reaching out to other people who are thru hikers or were preparing for the same thru hike that I was doing or even on any of the other trails. Talking to them is so much fun. Like, I mean, these are people that you can like, you know, swap gear ideas back and forth with, logistics, things like that. So definitely do that. There's great ways to do that. You can search hashtags wherever on Instagram is really helpful. There's a new website called Hikerlink. Hikerlink.co, which is done by thetrek.co. Really cool. I've connected with some people there. I highly recommend getting on, you know, and finding people that are doing the same thing that you're going to be doing because they, I don't know, it's just fun. It's like making friends. So I've really enjoyed it. So again, in closing, like this is what I've been doing to prepare that I have found on my own through my own research and speaking with other, you know, thru hikers, listening to podcasts of other hikers that have done these trails. I might do a follow-up video to this when I'm done to see, you know, what I might have done differently because again, I've never done this before. So, but I hope that some of the information that I've shared will, you know, kind of get you excited to start preparing for your hike and some of it might be helpful in preparing for whatever you've got planned. I really hope that like someday you can just really just decide to do it, pull that trigger and pick that day that you're gonna go and start preparing. If you found anything valuable in this, please let me know. I'd really love to hear about it. Or, you know, let me know and anyone else who's viewing this video know down in the comments what you have been doing to prepare for your thru hike. Again, I will be posting videos. My next video will probably be from the trail, which is very exciting. I am part of the Trail Correspondence Podcast. Just search Trail Correspondence Podcast and you can find how to get there. I'll include a link below. I'll be posting on Instagram. You can follow me there. Like and subscribe if you want to keep following along. I really look forward to making the next video because I'm going to be on the trail, which is just like, this week's been weird. It's been 2 days and like, I'm just like, what? Like, this is happening. And it's, I don't know. I'm not fully comprehending it yet, I don't think. Thanks for watching and we'll catch you in the next video.